इल्ला मन ताबा व आमना व अमिला अमलन सालिहन, एक्सेप्ट दोज हु मेक तौबा। नाउ व्हाट इज तौबा? ताबा यतूबो मींस टू रिटर्न, रिटर्निंग टुवर्ड्स अल्लाह, रिटर्निंग टुवर्ड्स हिज ओबीडियंस। बिकॉज व्हेन यू कमिटेड अ सिन, यू ब्रोक सम ऑफ हिज लॉज, यू एक्टेड अगेंस्ट सम ऑफ हिज इंजंक्शंस, एज इफ यू टर्न्ड योर फेस अवे फ्रॉम हिम, नाउ यू रिपेंट, यू हैव अ डीप फीलिंग दैट आई हैव डन समथिंग रॉन्ग, आई शुडंट हैव डन इट। Then there is a feeling, I must return to my Allah. I should ask for His forgiveness. This is Tawbah. And the conditions of Tawbah, they have been enumerated by the ulama from various ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. For each Tawbah to be true, it should fulfill three conditions. Number one, there should be real and actual repentance. Number two, there should be a firm resolve not to commit that act or that sin again. And number three, to actually give it up once, you have to give it up. Unless you fulfill these three conditions, you only repeat the words of Tawbah, Astaghfirullah Rabbi min kulli zambin wa atubu ilayh. You might be repeating it 1,000 times or 1,000,000 times. It's not Tawbah at all. These are the necessary preconditions of a true Tawbah. We shall have this word, you know, in the next lesson. That is Surah At-Tahrim. Ya ayyuhallazina amanu tubu ilallahi tawbatan nasuha. Oh, you who believe, turn towards Allah. Make tawbah towards Allah. But this should be a pure tawbah with the total sincerity. Not that you are just repeating the words of tawbah and you have made it also a zikr. Going on repeating the word. This is not tawbah unless, as I told you, three conditions. And these three conditions are regarding the sins which are related to the rights of Allah. If there is some sin relating to the right of a man, then there is a fourth additional condition. Three conditions the same. True repentance in your heart. Firm resolve never to commit that act again. Thirdly, to actually give it up. And fourthly, to ask forgiveness or compensate the person whom you had done committed some injury. It's only he who can forgive. Allah will not forgive you. Huququllah, he will forgive. He has told us that you can help, you can hope that I will forgive you my huquq. You can have the hope, but I am not going to forgive the huquq of the people. Only they can forgive. And that is why, you know, once the Prophet asked a question from the Sahaba, Atadruna Manil Muflis? Do you know who is a poor person? Muflis, who has no money? The answer was, and people were astonished why the Prophet has asked this question. They said, Al Muflis wa indana man la dirhama lahu wa la dinara. O Messenger of Allah, we think that a person who doesn't possess any dirham nor dinar, well, he is a Muflis. He said, no. The muflis of my ummah will be a person who will come on the day of judgment with a very big load of salah, very big load of psalm, and these, you know, maybe hajj and umrah. But he has abused that person. He has cheated that person. He took away the money wrongfully from that person. And now those claimants will come before Allah, oh Allah, he cheated me. He deprived me of my certain right. He deprived me of my money. Then you know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give somebody, some claimant, all his prayers. You go, take his prayers. Because there's no cash now. You can't pay in dollars or in dinars or dirham. The only cash is the good deeds that you have brought with you. You can compensate only with the good deeds. So all his prayers will be given to some claimant. All his psalm and fasting given to another till that time that no good deeds remain with him and the claimants are still there. Then their gunah, their, you know, sins will be added to his account. Well, put your sins in his scale, and he will be sent and thrown into paradise, into Jahannam, into the fire of hell due to the sins of other people. The Prophet said, he is the real Mukhlis of my Ummah. So that was the natural way of his teaching people. Asking a question, Atadruna Manil Mufris? Do you know who is a Mufris? Al-Mufris o indana, balladihama lahu ala dinara, la. Al-Mufris o min ummati is such and such one. So this is the fourth additional condition of Tawbah regarding sins and ill-doings which are related to the rights of people.